The new year is upon us, and you know what that means? An amazing cliche excuse for a fresh start. And I will take any opportunity, any excuse that's presented to me. These habits I'm sharing with you today are the most core, the most transformative, the most foundational to who I am. And I know for a fact, if you can adopt these, some of them, all of them, it will have a huge, profound impact in your life. We're gonna start with what I like to call morning motivation. What I do is I wake immediately up, I go in the shower, and I turn on something very specifically and intentionally designed to get me in the right mindset, get me motivated, inspired, and just in the right mindset for the day. A lot of times in the morning, we're groggy. Immediately the stress starts to infiltrate our mind. So by forcing yourself to listen to something that gets you thinking positively and that uplifts you and gets you in that right mindset, you need to find something that really resonates with you. For me, I love Jay Shetty. He has a podcast, he's a motivational speaker. And when he talks, he just like speaks to my soul and he really gets me on the right track. Next up, if you are a coffee drinker, try butter coffee. This for me, I call it my limitless fuel. If you have not heard of this, it's also called bulletproof coffee. It was kind of popular in like 2016. I used to do it and it stopped for whatever reason. And now I'm back and oh my goodness, I am back with a vengeance. It is so good. So what you're doing here is you're adding some healthy fat into your coffee so that the benefit of the coffee is more sustained. It just feels better. I feel so sharp and focused and ready to take on the day. Also prevents me from getting a caffeine crash, which is amazing. I don't get the jitters. I don't get that edgy feeling. So all I do here is I make my coffee as normal. I add in 1 tablespoon of unsalted grass-fed butter and 1 tablespoon of MCT oil, AKA unrefined coconut oil. Blend that up with my little mini electric whisk. Drink that instead of just my regular coffee. Have that and I just feel focused and ready to take on the day. Next one, instead of focusing on being an early bird, being a morning person, I say no, don't focus on being a morning person. Focus on just going to bed earlier. If you do that, if you can get your bedtime routine in order, the morning just naturally works itself out. First is just getting unready a lot earlier. So as soon as the kids go down, get ready for bed, like 7:30, I get myself ready for bed. My biggest tip here, if you can do this, just literally try it for one night and come back and tell me how well it works. Turn off your phone, turn off your TV, and read a book. It just naturally tires your eyes, tires your mind, and allows you to fall asleep so fast. I'm usually out within 15 minutes. So it's taken me forever to read books because I fall asleep so quickly. But look, whatever works, just wait and see how much easier and faster you fall asleep. Next up, I love this one, and that is adding fruits and or vegetables to every meal. It is so manageable and so doable just to commit to adding a fruit and or a vegetable to every meal, no matter what you're eating. So even if you're having mac and cheese for lunch, add a side of broccoli to it. The next one related to that is have healthy snacks abundantly throughout your house and not just in your pantry. Keep those healthy snacks where you need them, where your cravings strike. Because for me, that's where my downfall is. Like I can be good, I can be healthy, but those snacks, ooh, they get me. So at my desk, by my bedside, even in my bathroom, I have my healthy snacks. And this also applies to your kids. Keep healthier options in the house and get rid of the junky ones. And the best and most affordable place to get healthier for you snacks, in my opinion, is through Thrive Market. I love Thrive. They're a long-term partner with my YouTube channel, and they're very kindly sponsoring today's video. And before you tune out, before you skip ahead, you guys, they have given me the most insane offer. And as far as I'm aware, it's only for me and my followers, and that is 40% off your first order and free gifts. So you can load up on all your healthy snacks. Let's say spend $100 and get $40 off. Like that is such an amazing deal. Thrive Market has all healthier for you household products, not just snacks, cleaning products, baby products, even pet products. So anything you need for your household, pick it up from Thrive and you're gonna save money. It's like a Costco model. You become a member with Thrive and then you are locked in to their membership saving. And you can even see there right on the website how much you're saving on each item. And then stack that on top with my 40% off code. My stepmom actually has a lot of different food and dietary restrictions. And she told me that Thrive was the best recommendation I ever gave her because you can go on and shop by food restriction or food allergy or even diet or lifestyle preference. I don't have have to mess with going to the grocery store. I find it so much easier and more efficient to do my shopping. I just do it all through the app. I have auto ship for my most common products. I love their spray avocado oil. Avocado oil has a higher smoke point, just better for you. The organic dried mangoes, my favorite ever, just amazing healthy snack. I keep this by my desk. To make your butter coffee, I get my organic MCT oil from Thrive. For Carter, the Smart Bars are, in my opinion, my number one favorite kids' healthier snack item. They're organic almond butter in a squeezy tube. Game changing, just squeeze it out. So I could not recommend them more to start your year off on the right track, get healthier for you products in your house, and you can save 40% off your first order. So I will have all of the details and my discount code listed down in the description box and as the first pinned comment, so definitely try them out. Huge thing I started doing is making more of a priority to manage my negative thoughts and stress and anxiety, and I have specific things that I'm doing that I wanted to share. So I have this app, I found it randomly, it's called Thought Diary, and it's basically like a therapist within an app. So it checks in with you throughout the day, you log how you're doing, and then based on that, you can walk through other exercises of like coming up with a plan or getting over intrusive negative thoughts or even focusing on gratitude. There's so many different things, and I will go through the exercises in the app until I feel better. Like I just keep going and going, and I genuinely feel like this has helped me so much. So anytime I start to feel like those negative thoughts coming in or stress taking over, I'll just open the app and start doing exercises on here, because my biggest hurdle is my own self. And I know a lot of you feel that and can relate to that, and just being kinder to myself. And specifically, one of the things I learned from the app, a way to reframe your problems and your stresses that come up in life. What would you say to a dear friend who is going through the exact same problem and having the same thoughts? Chances are you would be a lot kinder, more compassionate, and give them great advice. So you need to talk to yourself that same way. Next biggest thing is don't rely on motivation to change your life. Chances are you might have motivation right now at the start of the year, feel inspired, you feel motivated, you're watching videos like this, but that's gonna fade.
So. Whoa, you're telling me that I'm not going to be the Coney Island hot dog eating world champion of 2022? I feel attacked! I just bought 42 cases of hot dogs for practicing. Yes, I know the house smells like hot dogs, but that's also the smell of victory.
So instead of relying on motivation, rely on habits and routines, and I specifically like tiny habits. That's my new thing. I did an entire video on tiny habits. I highly suggest you watch that one next. I will link it down below. Make your habits that you're trying to start very small, very manageable, very doable, and build on those day after day. So specifically, a little tiny habit exercise that you can do. I just did this for my new year. Start with a brain dump of all the habits that you would like to adopt in your life. So then take that list and break it down into three subgroups. First one, your top three most important habits that you'd like to start. Next are the easiest habits that would be the quickest, easiest to start. And then the third grouping are the next three, the ones that you can start immediately. Then you'll have your list of 9 habits to tackle for the new year. Make them very tiny, very manageable. Like one of mine is just working out for 10 minutes a day. Not a full workout, not an hour long workout. And it's so small, so manageable that there's no excuse to not do it. And from that point, after I do 5 minutes, if I'm feeling up to it, and only if I'm feeling up to it, I will continue going. But that is my preferred method for building new habits. Next up, set self-care goals for yourself and take those very seriously. That's what I realized I'm really missing out in my life. As a mom, I'm like taking care of everyone else, taking care of the household, I'm taking care of my work, but I haven't been taking care of myself, and that is just as important, if not more important. My daily self-care goal is to have my morning coffee, my butter coffee, in peace, and thinking about all the things I'm grateful for. My weekly self-care goal is to have a decadent bath. Read my book, get the music going, get the bubbles in there. Like that feels so good. And then my monthly self-care goal is to have a monthly massage, which I know to some people might sound over the top too much, but for me, that is so worth it. Like, nothing makes me feel more relaxed and happier than a good massage. So leave down in the comments right now, what are your self-care goals? I wanna know, I wanna be inspired by yours. Kind of related to the self-care, but different in a very important way, is coming up with some creative outlet or hobby. So I kind of have two that I've been doing. One is diamond painting, which I talked about in my Christmas gift ideas guide, because I'm giving this to everyone as a Christmas gift this year as a way to de-stress and just do something fun and creative. But it's just like what it sounds like. You individually put these little diamonds on these paintings, and it's so cathartic and relaxing and almost meditative. Or it might be adult coloring, it might be knitting, it might be painting or pottery or something. Just try to have one creative outlet. And last but definitely not least, I'm making a really big commitment and habit of limiting my social media use. I think to a certain point, I love social media, the connections, the ideas, the inspiration, like there's so much benefit to it. But after a certain point, it can become detrimental. You're losing focus, you're losing productivity. So specifically what I'm doing is, first, I'm unfollowing all the accounts that don't lift me up, that don't bring me joy, that aren't really adding value to my life. Next, if you have an iPhone, you can go into settings, screen time, and app usage, and set specific limits for yourself. So for me specifically, I've set my downtime to be between 9 p.m. and 9 p.m. where I can only use a few of my most favorite apps. I have Instagram turned off. Also, as I mentioned, I put my phone away and focus on reading a book at night now instead of just being on my phone, because that wakes you up, that inhibits melatonin production. So I just like to put it away. And also, if you've watched to this point, I have a huge favor for you. If you could let me know what you would like to see more of from my YouTube channel, what I can help you with in this new year, please leave it down in the comments. I really value your feedback. I take it seriously. What type of content do you want to see more of? What topics do you want to see me cover? Please leave that down in the comments. I would really appreciate it. Don't forget to subscribe if you're new, and also take advantage of my huge discount code for Thrive Market. They have everything on there, and I will have my link down in the description box along with some of my favorite products if you need some ideas. Thank you as always so much for watching, and I will see you soon with a new video. Bye.